starting that the single university is Silicon Valley. We must look at exponential technology. We must look at this 10 to the power of 9 billion plus impact. This billion plus impact has got tremendous business opportunities. Please look at that. We must increase our bandwidth. We must read a lot. We must not only be unidimensional techies. We must be multi-dimensional personality, where we have a few liberal knowledge of life sciences, social sciences, all sectors. Increase our horizons, increase our bandwidth, so that we are more resilient.
Cloud is great. It solves a lot of real-world problems, but it's not just one cloud anymore. Public clouds, private clouds, edge clouds. The average business uses 5 different cloud providers. It's become chaotic and complex, with unpredictable costs, inconsistent security, multiple management tools, and different formats for workloads that span cloud platforms and providers. But it doesn't have to be that way. The Dell Technologies Cloud, powered by VMware, can be the one constant across your clouds. It brings consistent infrastructure and operations to your multi-cloud environment, so you can choose the right cloud for each application. A public cloud that lets you easily tap into services, a private cloud that's fully under your control, or the edge with cloud as a service. With a true hybrid cloud experience, your business becomes more agile with simple workload migration and easy onboarding for new assets. Your teams get to market faster. With simplified operations and automated processes, you reduce risk and strengthen your security profile. And with Dell Technologies Cloud, you have flexible consumption options, reducing your total cost of ownership. Like it or not, the business world often requires many clouds. Now, that's easier than ever, with consistent infrastructure, operations, and services across all your clouds. You get the cloud without the chaos. The Dell Technologies Cloud.
When I met Sri Hansraj Verma about 6 months ago in Chennai, India, one of the things that struck me was that he's a very, very different IAS officer. He had such interesting perspectives on everything, on technology, on how technology can be used to make life better for people at the bottom of the pyramid. That's what struck me. And that empathy that he had with people out there at the bottom of the pyramid was what struck me really as different from an IAS officer that I've met many IAS officers in my life. And that's why I invited him to do this keynote. And I think he's going to talk about the imperative of forging a societal connect by the IT sector. So while we're doing a lot of great things in IT, how does that become relevant for society? And that's the thing that he's going to talk about. Sri Hansraj Verma has had a very, very distinguished career. He's been an IAS officer for many years now, and he was started off as a district collector in Salem. He handled a whole lot of. He was chairman of Tamil Nadu Electricity Board along the way. Currently, he's the additional chief secretary for Panchayati Raj and Rural Development and IT. So he's got two of the most important functions, I think, in a typical government setup in India. One, looking at the people that are there in the rural areas, and that's where the bulk of the population resides, and then seeing how IT can be an enabler to make their lives better. So I'm going to request Sri Hansraj Verma to address us. Thank you, sir, for staying up so late in Chennai, and we look forward to hearing you over the next 15-20 minutes and your perspectives. Over to you, sir.
Thank you, Vijay. And I warm evening to all the panelists and the audience. I'm a career bureaucrat with more than 34 years plus of service in the civil service, in the TN cadre. These 34 years have taken to diverse assignments, right from being on the board of Titan Industries to sitting in the Panchayat Bhavans with the self-help group members, discussing the issues. Right from supercritical power stations to tigers, all who did conservation. So this range has taken me, and today I sit at the cusp and convergence of two very critical areas. Rural development, Panchayat Raj, that is the local self-government for the rural areas, and the IT department. So when Vijay met me, I thought, what should my subject be for the TICON 2020? The subject I chose was the imperative of forging a social connect for the IT professionals, IT sectors. And this is very relevant today. Friends, let me start with the path-breaking announcements made by the Honorable Prime Minister of India from the ramparts of Red Fort during his independence speeches. So the major announcements are Swachh Bharat Mission, Jal Jeevan Mission, Broadband Mission for connecting all the 6 lakh villages in India on the OFC network, and recently for providing low-cost, high-quality sanitary napkins to the rural people. These are very, very path-breaking, and these are nation-building announcements. Also, the Honorable Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, who is a true son of the soil, has got a very clear focus on agriculture and water conservation. Today, in this COVID context, with telecom and IT being game changers, we need to use this force multiplier for the soil. So today I will cover 7 areas that have got relevance bearing convergence between the society and IT. The 7 areas are, first is jobs for the rural youth. The second area is women empowerment. Third is conservation, wildlife, forest conservation, biodiversity conservation. Fourth is water management and conservation. Fifth is MSMEs and Industry 4.0. Sixth is child welfare and online education. And the last is resilience in the communities, resilience in the IT professionals. So friends, let me start with the first one, job creation rural areas. India is a young nation with the average age being 29 years. The youth is aspirational, the youth is impatient. We need to find meaningful and sustainable jobs for the youth. Recently, we had a very interesting brainstorming session with some of the key stakeholders in Tamil Nadu. The Sridhar Vembu of the Zoho Corporation, STPI, the training wings of the government of Tamil Nadu to train the rural youth. How do we create jobs in the tier 2, tier 3 towns of Tamil Nadu, in the big village panchayats, which are sustainable? It is eminently doable. The model of Zoho, led by Sridhar Vembu, is a role model for all of us. He operates in a small town of Tenkasi in southern Tamil Nadu, where he gives employment to the rural youth there. In partnership with him and with the STPI, the software technology parks of India, and the various schemes, we can easily create meaningful jobs for the youth in rural areas. With these jobs, migration to cities is not required anymore in TS. With good infrastructure, good office network, and using the government infrastructure already in place, the brick and mortar, can easily create the infrastructure for these jobs. The next wave of innovation and creativity will come from rural areas. And Tamil Nadu, with its good rural urban dispersal, good infrastructure, community infrastructure, high levels of education, is ideally posed for creating these jobs. So this is the first area we must all focus on, and all of stakeholders work on that. Second area is women empowerment. Any development which is not engendered is endangered. Tamil Nadu was the pioneer of self-help group movement in India. This was given the impetus by the late Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, Dr. Jayalalitha. She was passionate about women empowerment. The women empowerment of Tamil Nadu, with about 1 million+ members in urban rural areas, are the social capital of Tamil Nadu. Can we empower them? Can we give them market access for products? Can we give them access for inputs using technology? Rural tourism is going to be a big job creator days to come. These self-help group members are going to play a major role in that. Today, tourists don't want tourism in the big towns. They want immersive tourism where they can tell a story back home. Yes. These self-help group members with their homestays, local cuisines, local guides are the ideal candidates for promoting this. IT professionals and IT sector should definitely encourage this. India is a land of rich history and culture. Every village, every small town has got a history to tell, a tale to tell. It's got a tremendous potential for rural tourism. The other area is agriculture. Women are involved in agriculture. They form themselves into farmer producer organizations, FPCs. Using them, giving the latest technology to them, we can empower them to get the best price for their produce, give them the best inputs for their agri practices. Yes. Other areas, microfinance. Using technology, we can ensure that in real time, we know the status of the processing of the loan application. How do they manage their group finances in a more effective manner so that they are able to make an impact at the rural level? So these are some of the areas where we can use the social capital of women empowerment for the benefit of society. Our motto is the next wave of growth development in India is going to be TETG, technology enabled transformative growth. We cannot have any more incremental growth. We need transformative growth. The next area is conservation, forest, wildlife and biodiversity conservation. You have to recall the words of late Mr. B.N. Ugandhar, who is the father of Satyam Nadella. He was a Kerry bureaucrat, and as I met him as a member of the Planning Commission, he used to always say the western ghats of India, which are Kerala to Maharashtra, are one of the best forests in the world. They are sacred geography. We must conserve them. These words ring you today. So we must all join together. If you have visited the western ghats, you will not find any better place than that. Now, what is the relevance? First is wildlife conservation. We have the best of the species in tigers, elephants, carnivores, herbivores. We must work for the conservation. Then we have the biodiversity. We have the Nilgiri biosphere. We have the Agastya biosphere. The Gulf of Manna biosphere. Yes. These biospheres in Western Ghats have some of the best biodiversity resources in India. India is a very rich nation in biodiversity resources. Are we able to ensure that the exploitation of the biodiversity resources ensures that the wealth goes back to the community? Do they get the due share? Can you ensure that this biodiversity resources, every flora extracted from here, Tamil Nadu or in the rest of India, used for a medical preparation abroad, the money that due to the community goes back to them? Can we deploy technology for ensuring that these biodiversity resources, both flora and fauna, are used for the betterment of society? It is for the IT professionals to decide on that. The next area is wildlife crime. Friends, IT sector and professionals have got a tremendous network worldwide. Today, wildlife crime is a matter of grave concern. We are losing species by the day. Please look up CITES, the Convention of International Treaty for Endangered Species. Become a member of that. Associate with organizations involved with protection of wildlife and wildlife prevention of crime. The dark net is used for several of these activities. So IT sector with its network influence can play an important role in this. The next area is water conservation, water management. Honorable Prime Minister announced the Swachh Bharat Mission and the Jal Jeevan Mission. Swachh Bharat Mission was about sanitation. Provision of toilets for every individual in India, household in India. This is nation being at its best, for which we need good quality water. Then we have the Jal Shakti Abhiyan for water conservation of the water bodies and the Jal Jeevan Mission, piped water supply to every household by 2024. Piped supply of a minimum of 55 LPCD per household of proper quality water. You hear of this flooding of urban areas. Why is it so? because our traditional water bodies have not been maintained. We find lot of IT professionals in Chennai getting involved in restoration of water bodies. Pallikaranai marsh was quite familiar to you. It's one of the iconic biospheres of Chennai. It is the sump that absorbs the rainwater here. Tamil Nadu is a lot of lakes. So together, can we come together for the conservation of water bodies? For Jal Jeevan Mission, can we use IoT and the latest technology in ensuring proper monitoring of the water quality, proper monitoring of the reservoirs and the groundwater table, proper monitoring of the quality in which we ensure that there are no heavy metals or fluorides supplied to the household? Technology is going to play an important role in this. Next, we come to MSMEs and Industry 4.0. Friends, MSMEs are the backbone of Indian economy. They are the huge employment creators and generators. If India has to be truly Atmanirbhar, then our MSMEs have to be competitive. We must be competitive on the world stage. How do they make it happen? We must adopt Industry 4.0 for them. Tamil Nadu, which is the second largest economy in India, has got the largest MSME base in the country. And these MSMEs are very, very potential MSMEs for adoption of Industry 4.0. There's huge scope here where we can come together and make our MSMEs competitive at the world stage, make India truly Atmanirbhar, and create meaningful jobs for the youth in the manufacturing sector. The next area is child welfare and online education. UNICEF says 30% of the children don't have access to online education. It's a matter of concern. How do we come together and ensure that children in the rural areas don't get left behind on account of the digital divide, on account of COVID-19 or online education? We must work together on this. Here we are part of the BharatNet network, in which we're going to lay high-speed broadband network, OCO network, to all the villages of Tamil Nadu. This will be able to ensure that the children in the rural areas are on par with the children in urban areas as far as access to online education, content for online education is concerned. Here again, IT professionals, the IT sector, can play a role. Another area is the Poshan Abhiyan. It is a nutritional Abhiyan for the children in India. We have issues of nutrition, malnutrition, underweight, stunting. Can you all come together and work out a system which you all contribute to ensure that the children of India are able to get the future they deserve by ensuring that proper interventions based on state policy plus IT interventions ensure that they are able to monitor their nutrient status, height-weight ratio, to ensure that when they are at the growth stage, they are able to get the right supplements. Technology will play a role here. Friends, and the last thing is resilience. IT Department of Tamil Nadu, NASSCOM, has done a lot of pioneering work in resilience in COVID times for the IT professionals. We have conducted such serious webinars for the emotional mental well-being of the IT professionals. Today, resilience is extremely important. Similarly, we work with the rural communities through a system of barefoot counselors for building resilience in this rural community. There is distress on account of COVID. How do you ensure that distress, anxiety, or livelihood, the future, is contained by the first line of defense by these barefoot counselors who look into this well-being of the community? Every individual of India is a national asset. His or her well-being is a primary concern for all of us, whether it's IT professional or persons in the rural community. If a person is resilient, the society is resilient. If society is resilient, his organization is resilient, and the nation is resilient. In this context, I'd like to make two sources. First is from the book Abundance by Peter Diamandis and Steve Kotler, in which he says, starting that the single university is Silicon Valley, we must look at exponential technology. We must look at this 10 to the power of 9 billion plus impact. this billion plus impact has got tremendous business opportunities. Please look at that. The second is the book by Tim Mattis and Link West, Pure Science to Lead. He talks about resilience here. With my appeal and request to all the IT professionals is that we must increase our bandwidth. We must read a lot. We must not be unidimensional techies. We must be multidimensional personalities where we have a few liberal knowledge of life sciences, social sciences, all sectors. Increase our horizons, increase our bandwidth so that we are more resilient. In the course of my career, I often find when we go to the beaches of Besant Nagar for the conservation of olive lily turtles, eggshells and hatchlings, a lot of IT professionals participate there. When I was interacting with Ram Kumar, the CEO, the former CEO, head of TTS India, he mentioned a very interesting thing. He says, when we interview the IT professionals, they're just not looking for a job. They also ask a very pertinent question. They ask, can this organization give me a platform for making an impact for the society? That's a very, very encouraging positive sign. A lot of CTS professionals in Chennai region do pro bono service in rural areas during weekends. This is the kind of connect we want. I have seen a lot of IT professional groups on Harley Davidson's on the Chennai and Bangalore highway areas. Yes, that's a part of the downtime for them, yes. But there's also another dimension where the society calls them. So can we have the synergy between the social capital, the self-help groups, the communities in the rural areas, and the intellectual capital, the network of the IT professionals, and take India to its rightful place? As a career bureaucrat who has served 34 years in the civil service, I am very optimistic and very confident and very hopeful that, yes, this synergy, this partnership between the social capital of the state, of the nation, and the intellectual capital and the power of network of the IT professionals will make a huge impact. So my appeal to all the audience, in particular, since I am alumnus of BITS Pilani, to all the BITSins in the audience, and to also the members of the ATE, American Tamil Entrepreneur Associations, that please take that small half step, proactive half step. The state, the government will take the other half step. Let's work together. Make each of your steps, your efforts count. Stand up and make the difference. If my any message is there for the Tycon audience is that let us together harness the power of the social capital, technology and the commitment and networks of the IT professional IT sector to make the difference. And collectively, we can all make the difference. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, sir, for that very, very interesting perspective. I think you opened up so many areas and you opened up so many opportunities for entrepreneurs across the world, I think, to come and participate in governance and making lives better for people both in urban as well as rural areas. And thank you for bringing the breadth of the breadth of the discussion to this conference.